Very good evening to JCRCians and welcome to TV Talk with Pooja Bajoria. So let's begin with today's headline. IEEE, a global platform for students' innovation. Narendra Modi interacted with students on topic Pariksha Pe Charcha. Jaipur Youth Festival, an initiative for youngsters. Indian women's football team defeated Indonesia in their second match in Jakarta. Are biopics a new face of cinema? Bionic lenses are computer-generated display. Now continue the further bulletin with reporters. The Institute of Electrical and Electronic Engineers, that is IEEE, a global association, an organization of professionals working towards the development, implementation and maintenance of technology-centered products and services. The IEEE is best known for developing standards for the computer and electronic industry. This will help students to get involved in the new standards of technologies. For more information, our reporter talked to Professor Vijay Janyani, MNIT Chairperson, IEEE Rajasthan Subsection.
So, what is IEEE and how does it work?
Actually, IEEE is a short form for Institution of Electronics and Electrical Engineers. And it is actually one of the world's biggest technical professional societies, which is working for the benefit of humanity, for the advancement of technical knowledge. Basically, it focuses on electrical, electronics and computer engineers, but of course other people from science background, they also are a part of it. We have over around 5 lakh members across the world, which are members of this, and great scientists like Thomas Alva Edison and Graham Bell, they were the founding members of this society. And today, I think it's a very important resource for all the students who are aspiring to get new knowledge, to get connected to the network of similar professionals and experts. And I'm very happy to note that today, JECRC University has inaugurated the student chapter of IEEE student branch.
With less than a month to go for the class 10th and class 12th examinations, PM Modi discussed various ways to handle the exam stress in the interactive session at the Talcadora Stadium, where students from across the country got a chance to participate. JECRC University also had a screening of Pariksha Pe Charcha in its seminar hall. Also, counseling students whom parents often scold for not listening to them, he said that it is important to start a conversation with parents. Once a conversation has begun, it is possible for students to put across a point to the parents and find a solution to everything. The Prime Minister subtly criticized parents who put excessive pressure on their children to perform, just so that they can boast about children's achievements in their social gatherings. Jaipur Youth Festival is a collective effort to put young minds that strive to achieve young indulgence and advancement of our nation. The youth of our nation is raging with ambition to work for the benefit of our society. The Jaipur Youth Festival provides a platform to those aspiring youth who come forward and learn, express, interact and work for the betterment of our country. In this four-day event, every aspect is covered related to our young generation. Various youth-related issues were discussed and opportunities were given to them to express through various mediums such as art, music and literature, etc. Indian women's football team notched up a second successive victory over Indonesia, beating the host 2-0 in the second friendly match in Jakarta on Wednesday. While Sanju scored in the first half, Dangmai Grace netted the second goal just minute ahead of the full-time whistle. India has defeated Indonesia 3-0 in the previous match on Sunday. As head coach Maimoul Rocky egged her team on, Sanju put the visitors into the lead with a perfectly placed shot in the top right corner after Ratnabala played her through into the Indonesian penalty area. Biographical film or biopic is a film that dramatizes the life of a non-fictional or historical personality. Such films show the life of a historical person and the central character's real name is used. Such films are becoming so trending these days and even public response towards these films are on high level. With the audience taking interest in the story of their role models, these biopics are competing tough against commercial films, such as Dangal, Uri the Surgical Strike, such movies is performing decently in the box office. Through analysis, it could be figured that biopics are becoming trending nowadays as to serve education and entertainment in the same platter with high profit.
So do you think that biographical films are new face of media?
I have four examples for this. One, Anupam Kher starred the accidental Prime Minister. Two, that is Nawazuddin Siddiqui starred Thackeray. Three, that is Kangana Ranaut starred Manikarnika, the Queen of Jhansi. And four, that is Rajkumar Hirani starred Sanju. So we have these four films comes into our mind when we speak out about biopics of this year. But this is not true. We have 40 films this year which were released and based on biography of renowned people. So we just come to know about this thing that biopics have, you know, it's a new trend, emerging trend in Bollywood, but it is not. Biopics have always been made in India. You know, from Mughal-e-Azam to Jodha Akbar. Although it has some fantasy and imaginative elements as well, but it was there. But the thing which is different now, what is different now? But the thing which is different now is we are making more realistic biopics now because audiences are interested in real stories now, you know. So the fantasy elements of Hindi cinema, Hindi movies is changing. This is the most important thing. So a biopic, apart from obvious realism, you know, it's needs to have a sense of inspiration now. This is what audience demands. So yes, biopics are increasing, 40 films this year, but it doesn't have much fantasy and imaginative elements, but realistic elements.
Bionic lens will have the form of a conventional contact lens with added bionics technology in the form of augmented reality, allowing the viewer to see a computer-generated display superimposed on the world outside. Experimental versions of these devices have been demonstrated, such as one developed by Sandia National Laboratories. The lens is expected to have more electronics and capabilities on the areas where the eye does not see. Engineers have tested the finished lenses on rabbits for up to 20 minutes and the animals showed no problems. That's all for today and thank you for watching.